Hello guys, this is Anita here from Smart Edicts by Ali and Tej. So you have been following us on our page and where Tejal is teaching you how to make sourdough starter. So usually you must have observed, like, with every feed you have been discarding some quantity of starter. So this discard is called the unfed starter, and which is also very good, like it's healthy. You can't say that it's gone unhealthy or you can't eat that. No, you can make various recipes with that discard also. So usually what I do is, like, if I don't want to keep on collecting, I just add it to my, you know, parathas which I'm making, and I just finish them off. Otherwise you can keep collecting in a common jar which will be always in the fridge. So whenever you're feeding and discarding, you can collect that discard into that common jar and keep on collecting, and try to use it within few days or within a week's time, because otherwise if you make after a long time, then you will find it very prominent sour. So there are plenty of recipes which you can make it out, like sweet dishes or salty dishes also. So when you're making a sweet recipes from discard, if you're not comfortable with the sourness, you can add a little bit of eating soda also into that. So when you're making the recipe, so today I'm starting, I'll be teaching you all how to make a sourdough lavash from the discard. Okay, so let's go. And if you have any doubts, you can ask in the comment section and we'll surely revert to you. So usually the starter is having the good bacteria, and same with the discard also. So don't feel that you're eating something very unhealthy. No, you have to utilize the discard which comes out with every feed. So for making the lavash, I am taking around 1 cup of whole wheat, 'cause many of the people won't be having kitchen scale, so we are trying to use the measurement in terms of cups. And then I'm taking my discard, 1/4 cup of discard. And then if you want, you'll be adding the flavoring agents. So if you have dried herbs, I'm using rosemary. If you don't have rosemary, you can use crushed garlic also, or whatever flavor you like in your lavash. So luckily I was having rosemary in my fridge, which got dried up, and you can see from green it has become blackish, but still having a good flavor. Salt according to the taste. Now in this I'll be adding the cold press oil. I usually use safflower cold press oil, which will be again 2 to 3 tablespoons. So here I am using 3 tablespoons. You can use pure ghee also. Now I'm mixing it. If you feel that, you know, the dough is very stiff, then in that case you can add a little bit of more water. Here I'm not adding any water. So if you find your discard is smelling very sour, and you're using it after a week or 2 weeks, so what I recommend is, like, you can add little few tablespoon of flour and water, mix it, feed it, and once it is bubbly, use it immediately so that the sourness is reduced. So you can follow this tip also. So yeah, I can see that the dough is not binding nicely, so I will use a little bit of water. So I'm adding half cup of water over here. So again, the water depends on what kind of flour you have taken. Here I have taken whole wheat, so it is taking more water. The maida dough won't, the maida flour won't take much of water. As the whole wheat has fiber in it, so that's the reason why they need more water. So make a nice dough out of this ball. Now you need to ensure that you are keeping it out for few hours. Like suppose if you are making same day, to ensure that you are fermenting it for 10 to 12 hours, which would be like 1 hour outside after kneading the dough, and then shifting it into the fridge, and by evening just roll them out and bake it. But over here I'm keeping it for 24 hours so that the flavor develops more. So as I said, like when you're making sweet savories from the discard, you can add pinch of soda also, depending on the quantity which you are making it, to overcome the sourness. Now I'll just so it's a stiff dough. Ensure that the dough is little bit stiff. Okay. Now I'll be keeping it, and I'll be keeping this immediately into the fridge because I'm fermenting it for 24 hours. So tomorrow again at the same time, I'll be rolling it and making my lavash. I'll show you how to roll your lavash before the bake, okay? So after fermenting of 24 hours, when you'll remove from the fridge, you'll be just making the small balls. And rolling it into just like chapati, very thin. But ensure that you're rolling it evenly. So they are, if you roll it evenly, the baking becomes easily. Otherwise, some part of the lavash will be baked and some part of the lavash will be unbaked. So in order to avoid that situation, you need to ensure that you're rolling it properly, evenly. Now after this, you'll be poking it. Yeah. and then you will cut it as per your desired shape. And now you will be layering it. Why we poke it? Because otherwise while baking the dough will puff up. So in order to avoid that situation, you need to poke the lavash properly. And then you will put it in the baking tray, and you'll be baking around in a preheated oven around between 150 to 160 degrees for 20 to 25 minutes. If you want, you can sprinkle a little bit of salt also before this, and you can bake it. Yeah, I hope you enjoyed this recipe, and if you have any doubts, please share please do ask your doubt in the comment section. Thank you so much for watching.
So guys, I've baked this wheat lavash at 150 degrees to 160 degrees, but you need to keep an eye while baking it. It took me around 20 minutes to bake these delicious lavash. It's having amazing aroma of rosemary. So I hope you have enjoyed this recipe. Thank you so much for watching us.